you will find just about every type of data visualization on an infographic at some point. You'll find bar charts and pie charts and scatter plots and heat maps and trend lines. They're all fair game for infographics. However, there are some particularly infographic-y things that people do, and there are some key concepts to know about creating data visualizations for infographics. For sort of standard data visualizations, charts and graphs that you're familiar with, the key concept is to make them simple and accessible. If, for example, I am trying to show the relative contributions to a certain program by country, and I give this on an infographic, that is going to be way, way, way too much detail. I need to simplify things in order to support my main point. If my main point is I want to highlight the major contributors, then I should probably do something like this, and make sure that I get all of those other much smaller contributors categorized under one slice of this pie chart instead of taking up so much space and making this graphic much more complex. There are, however, many different types of infographic-specific things that you won't find in other data visualizations, bar charts, pie charts, etc. To start, we're going to talk about something that isn't really a data visualization, but is kind of like it. You use visual markers on infographics in order to make textual content hit home better. So, for example, you can use an icon with text, as on this infographic for steps to apply for a child's passport. For step 4, where you want to highlight ID, they create a little icon of a driver's license, and you immediately know what step 4 is going to be about, even if you don't read the text. That visual marker really helps it cement in people's minds. You can also use an icon as a frame for textual information. Here, for a savings of $16 billion, you use a frame of a piggy bank, which immediately evokes savings, and $16 billion on top of it. The text of that number makes that information, again, cement in your audience's mind better. Using icons in actual data visualization also occurs across infographics. One of the most common ways, as you'll see on this infographic about local food in King County, Washington, is just straight up enumerations. Here, we have 13 James Beard Award-winning chefs, and we have 13 James Beard Awards located around it. We also have 20 restaurants per 10,000 people, and we have 20 icons next to that number 20 of forks and knives. We also use icons and counting for proportions. In this infographic about healthy eating, we say 8 in 10 Americans think advice about what to eat is conflicting, and we do something very common on infographics. We create an array of icons, here 10, and we sort of shade in or make colorful 8 of those, and 2 of them, we decrease the opacity, make them more transparent, or grayed out. This extends to something that I call partial fills, and this is sort of starting to get into using icons as actual graphs instead of just counting them. Here, when we want to show 61% of people, we use an icon of a person to represent 100% and fill up 61% of that person. Icons for graphs themselves are similarly used. If, for example, you have a bar chart, what you can do is instead of just drawing bars, you can stack icons. Here, they've put icons all the way to the top, and they've shaded in the relative amount that is filled. You can see that they're actually being fairly precise here. They have both the labels across the top and also partially filled shopping carts as well. You can also use an icon as sort of the background of a pie chart. Here, when we want to show that 13% of adults live in food insecure homes, we use an icon of a salad, and then we cut out a 13% slice to reinforce that statistic. Another very common infographic thing to do is to create scale comparisons using shapes and icons or fonts in order to show difference in size, change, or gravity. Here, when we want to talk about the billions spent in medical costs of diet-related chronic diseases, you can see that we're actually using a scale comparison. Obesity at the lower end and heart disease is much, much larger. You'll notice that not only the shapes scale proportionally, but also the fonts incise them. This is another design cue that reinforces how much more heart disease is impacting than obesity. In all things, when you are visualizing your data on your infographic, make sure that it is contributing to your information and those complex statistics being accessible. They should be easy to read. They also need to be in service of your overall main point or argument. So many times, students want to show that they've done so much research about a topic, and what happens is they cram way too much detail into their data visualizations. Remember that the more detail you put in, the less likely that major trends are going to be emphasized. And finally, take a step back from your data visualizations and make sure that you aren't using the same one over and over again. If you look at it and find that, oh, I've used 8 bar charts here, well, you probably should try something different in order to make your infographic accessible, easy to read, and engaging for your audience.